Good afternoon, everyone. Hope you learned a lot during this 1 week online AICT-IST sponsored induction program on the research paper writing and IP rights. On behalf of A.G. Patil Polytechnic Institute, I, G.M. Kulkarni, the Training and Placement Officer of the Institute, delighted to welcome you all for this valedictory function. And we have a guest of honor, Honorable Professor Vijay Vaidya sir, the Executive Secretary of IST New Delhi. We have Honorable Shekhar Jeulkar sir, Chartered Engineer and an eminent person from a metallurgical field with us. Along with them, we have Honorable President of Shanti Education Society, Shri A.G. Patil sir, Secretary Shri S.A. Patil sir, the Coordinator and Principal of Polytechnic, M.H. Sangule sir. I request all the participants to please mute, getting some disturbances. I welcome Dr. M.H. Sangule sir, Vice Principal Shri J.M. Jaketia sir, my colleagues and dear participants. It's been a splendid event for understanding the concepts of research paper writing and intellectual property rights. Through various aspects, we have been learning since last 6 days. The eminent personalities from all the corners of India have accepted our invitation and as a resource person, and they have guided all of us by sparing their valuable time. The discussions we had, dear participants, through the question answer session were truly qualitative, and we appreciate each one of you for your wholehearted involvement during all the sessions of this induction program. Right from inauguration to this valedictory function, your participation is not only amazing, but also a motivating factor for all the members of organizing committee. We thank you wholeheartedly. Now, I request coordinator of this event and the principal, Dr. M.H. Sangule sir, to address the audience. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Am I audible, sir?
Yes, you are very much audible, sir. You are good to go.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Very good afternoon to all. Today, chief guest for this validity function, Honorable Professor Vijay Vaidya sir, Executive Secretary, IST New Delhi, Honorable Engineer Shekhar Jeulkar sir, Chartered Engineer and Consultant to various industries, Honorable President of Shanti Education Society, Sri A.G. Patil sir, Secretary of Shanti Education Society, Sri S.A. Patil sir, Vice Principal J.M. Jaketia sir, all HOD and dear participants. I welcome you all for this validity function of 6 days online induction program on research paper writing and IP rights, which is sponsored by AICT-IST New Delhi. I am very much thankful to AICT-IST for giving this opportunity. From last 6 days, you all are attending these sessions and might have learned and enjoyed a lot. In these 6 days of induction program, different topics related to research paper and IP rights are covered. In this, Dr. Amardeep Pal from IIT Bombay has given the session on introduction to peer-reviewed journals. Professor Mrs. S.R. Sakre has explained research methodology and motivation to do research in qualitative and quantitative approach. Dr. Rajesh Khambayat has nicely explained the concept of educational research and he elaborated the case studies. Dr. Anita Divekar from IIT Bombay has highlighted the methods of measuring effectiveness of educational research. Dr. S.S. Wangikar has explained the research methodology, tools, techniques, applications, and its interpretation. She also briefly given the information about the techniques of research paper writing. Dr. V.V. Poddar has given the session on national education policy, so that everybody should make aware about this policy. Professor S.N. Upadhyay has elaborated the role of trademark and conveyed the overview of IPR laws in India. Mr. Sumit Sable has given the session on understanding patent and patent policy. Mr. Anish Sahasrabhute has nicely given the session on stress management. Mr. Hariprasad Madral has highlighted the concept of patentability and non-patentable. And today morning, Engineer Shekhar Jeurkar sir has explained the concept of intellectual property and artificial intelligence. I would like to express my sincere thanks to AICT IST for giving this opportunity to conduct induction program, that 6 days induction program on research paper writing and IP rights. So I request all participants to practice the knowledge acquired about the research paper writing and IP rights by publishing a research paper in any Scopus indexed reputed journal, and at least try to register a patent, and also motivate your students also. So that will be the real outcome of this induction program, which is sponsored by AICT IST. So without wasting much time, I wish you all the best. Take care. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Few participants have approached us for giving the feedback. So I request now to start with Sachin Patil, sir. If you can hear me, can you please start your audio and video? Sachin Patil, sir.
Yes, sir. Am I audible?
Yes, sir. If possible, you can start the video also.
Yes,
it's good. If possible, just rotate your mobile in a horizontal mode.
See, is it okay?
Okay, go ahead, sir.
First of all, good afternoon to all. I am Sachin Patil, working as a lecturer in RIT Islampur, and my department is science and humanities. My subject is chemistry. First of all, I would like to congratulate to all the organization committee of this FDP, that is research paper writing and IT rights, and the coordinators of this FDP. And I would like to thanks our principal sirs of AGP Polytechnics for supports of this FDP. After I attending this FDP, I got the total ideas and some doubts regarding the how to write the research paper effectively. So after I attending this 6 day workshop or FDP, I very much clear my doubts, and I hope these all the points are implementing in my research. Then this 6 day FDP is run very smoothly. When the problems which are raised solved by the organization and the coordinators of this FDP very smoothly, all the sessions conducted are very smoothly, and all the content of this 6 day FDP is very appropriate and which is very helpful in our futures. So all the committee members of this FDP is very helpful. They solve all the threats which are raised in these 6 day workshops. Once again, I would like to thanks to the principal sirs of AGP Polytechnic Solapur and the team members, coordinator, and all the team members of this FDP. And I hope all the participants are attend this workshop is very clearly mind and got the these points in covered, which is covered in this 6 day FDP. So thank you so much, sir, and all the best for the I hope you will organize this type of workshop in future, and definitely I would like to attend this workshop, sir, very nicely, sir.
Thank you, Sachin ji. Thank you very much for this.
Thank
motivation.
You, sir.
Surely thank we you. Are going to organize such workshops in future as well. Since last couple of years,
yes,
we are
yes.
organizing continuously, and AICT IST is supporting AG Patil Polytechnic Institute for conducting such activities. So thanks for your input. Now the
yes.
second participant who
thank
wish
you.
To give the feedback. Thank you, sir. Who wish to give feedback is Ms. Ankita Kulkarni, ma'am. Ma'am, can you please hear me? Can you please unmute yourself?
Oh
yes.
May, am I audible, sir?
You are very much audible.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Mrs. Ankita Kulkarni, Assistant Professor in Sanjeevan Engineering and Technology Institute, Panhala, in Engineering Physics Department. First of all, I would like to thank you, AICT, IST sponsored program organized by A.G. Patil College, Solapur, organized by organizing committee for giving me the opportunity to share my feedback. I would like to thank you for organizing this useful and informative induction refresher workshop. Presenters, speakers were very knowledgeable and offered valuable tips and information. I really enjoyed the program. I learned several key points of information that will greatly improve my ability to publish. Looking forward to any future seminars. Thank you. Thank you very much for providing this great platform to all of us. Thank you, organizers.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for your inputs. Now I request Priya Shinde ma'am to convey her feedback. Priya Shinde ma'am, can you hear me?
Yes, sir. Good afternoon to all of you. Thanks for giving me this opportunity to express my gratitude towards this FDP. I would like to congratulate to the management, principal, the coordinator, and all the team member for arranging such a knowledgeable session under this FDP. All the eminent speakers, they really delivered their expertise in well-organized manner. And yes, they also solved whatever the queries we raised, and definitely we gained the knowledge from it. And I hope in future, you are also going to arrange such a wonderful FDP, and for that, all the best. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for your valuable suggestion and your feedback.
Thank you, sir.
Dear participants, we are really energized with the kind words of all of you. So we'll try to continue this series of lectures related to research paper writing and IP rights. We are now at the point where we wish to have inputs or thought sharing by Shekhar Jeyurkar sir, the Honorable Chartered Engineer from Solapur. And I request him to convey his guest of honor remarks. Jeyurkar sir, you can over to you.
Yes, thank you. Honorable Chaugule sir, Honorable Vaidya sir, Professor Gajanan Kulkarni, the team of AGP conducting this particular program. You are really done a very good job of arranging this particular FDP sponsored by AICT and IST. These are the programs which are the value addition programs to us. Nowadays, these value additions are extremely important because for last 5 or 10 years, apart from our regular teaching, we have to impart knowledge to the students beyond our syllabus. Now, these particular programs will definitely give that scope to the students. If I learn all these things, I can park or I can deploy this particular information to the student. So this is really a very wonderful effort done by you. Second point which I want to highlight is that as the basic things, starting from the paper writing, then how to have this particular review of different papers, making a paper, highlighting that particular points, then publishing it into a Scopus Index journal. It looks very simple, but actually in practice, it is very difficult. A person who is undergoing this particular practice, he will know that what are the pains which are generated. And what I say that instead of getting a joy of publishing, he learns a lot while making these efforts to publish. And these efforts are extremely important for him. Paper publishing, once it is published, that okay, people will say, okay, you have done a good job. But what he learns is this particular process. So for me, it is this particular part which is important. Third point is that the patent is a very, what I can say, the neglected part in our society. So you have made a wonderful effort to bring it on the surface so that many of the staff members and the working professional understand what is patent and what he should do in a patent. What I suggest that A.G. Patel, being a good premier institution, you should start an innovative cell and a part that is related with the patent. You will find that a lot of funding is available through government for the deployment of this particular information through the research center conducted by Educational Institute. I have just highlighted that particular part. So I will suggest that you take the initiative. I will be very much glad to be a research or say faculty for that particular institution. Okay. So these are my some information and the concluding remarks with reference to the what you have conducted throughout this complete week. So I suggest that such particular participation should be increased. All the participants should promote the others to join such lectures, get the information. And what I will suggest that if you have such particular type of, say, patent, copyright, or trademark, or such on your name, you'll find that what goodwill and what status you acquire in the society, that is really wonderful. So I am experienced that for 2 or 3 months, that what is the change of this particular part after getting the patent, what is the acknowledgement got through the society and from the technical community. Okay, so with these few words, I will just thank you for giving me this particular opportunity to deliver a lecture and being a part of this valedictory function. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Jayankar sir. Would like to communicate that we are already in process of incubation center. The Government of India has sanctioned funds for that. So we'll definitely in a position to start with the incubation center, which will not only help the research and development activities, but also help with the IPR part. Now, dear participants, hold the breath, and I'm just going to introduce Professor Vijay Vaidya sir. We feel privileged, dear sir, to welcome you here at valedictory function of 1 week online AICTE-ISTE sponsored program. Dear participants, Professor Vijay Vaidya has obtained his BTech degree in civil engineering from Karnataka Regional Engineering College Suratkal, presently known as NIT Suratkal. I request participant, if someone has unmuted himself, I request, it's getting disturbance. Okay. So he has completed degree in 1981. Earlier in his career, he has worked for AFCON Limited Mumbai at different sites in Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Goa, Madhya Pradesh, etc. And also worked with the designer firm and did structural designing for different types of structures like residential, commercial, industrial, and public buildings. He had joined teaching field in 1985. Please pay your attention. He had joined the teaching field in 1985, almost 36 years back, as a lecturer in civil engineering department at Government Polytechnic. And since then, he continued to work in different capacities in Government of Maharashtra, which includes as a head of civil engineering, the training and placement officer of the institute, as a vice principal, and finally as a principal. He has worked in administration in DT as well, that is Directorate of Technical Education, Mumbai, as an assistant director. Later, he has worked as a deputy secretary in MSBT, that is Maharashtra State Board of Technical Education, Mumbai. This particular board, MSBT, as we all are aware, looking after the diploma activities. He has various achievements to his credits. During the tenure of principal of Government Polytechnic Kolhapur, the various programs of GP Kolhapur have been accredited by National Board of Accreditation, New Delhi. He was the pioneer in designing the G-Scheme curriculum for MSBT Mumbai. He has developed an online monitoring system of institutes for MSBT Mumbai, and it's still in practice. It is a very good initiative. He has been involved of the online monitoring. Also, dear participants, he has written a book on the valuation of civil engineering structures. He has attended various national and international conferences and presented his research work in these conferences. Dear friends, Professor White is an executive council member of IST since 2012, and he is presently serving as an executive secretary of IST. He has adopted various measures to reduce the expenses. So it's a key point that he has addressed as far as reducing the expenses of such a body. He has activated various programs and activities as per the policy of Honorable President and directives of Executive Council. We must appreciate Professor Vaidya for his hard work in the development and progress of IST. We really appreciate you, sir. So with this, now I request Professor Vijay Vaidya, sir, the Executive Secretary of IST New Delhi, to guide us on this occasion of Bal Dikshit function. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Jayant Pinjar, sir. Really, it was detailed introduction. So I think the participants must have learned a lot of things about me. Means I am not that much capable, but still,
sir, we have curtailed your information, brief information, because we have heard many times from our principal, Dr. Saugule, sir, about you. So it's a pleasant thing to listen to you right now, sir. We welcome you, sir. Please go ahead.
Thank you, Dr. Dynamic principal of this institute, and my good friend, Dr. Saugule, sir, respectable. Specialist in metallurgy, engineer Jeurkar sir, then other members, other dignitaries, A.G. Patil sir, president of this organization, trust, vice principal, and other dignitaries, and my dear participants. First of all, I feel it is my duty to congratulate Saugule sir and his team for organizing this program. Not because organizing the FDP, but the topic which they have selected, that is research paper writing and intellectual property rights. See, one thing, as already given or already in introduction, it was mentioned that I am from a polytechnic background, and I served in polytechnic system for around 34 years, and after that I have retired. So I have seen the transitions in polytechnic system, and in that means it is a really good thing that they are thinking of organizing a FDP in such a innovative topic. Because when I joined in 85 to Government Polytechnic, that time there were people who were having only diploma qualification and they were serving as a lecturer. And now whenever I am coming across with many institutes, many polytechnics, I see that there are many faculties are doctorate, they are PhD holders. See the transition, and this transition is already taken place, and with this such innovative approach that took identify such a research paper writing concept and to organize the FDP on this. So really Saugule sir and his team deserve appreciation. So really, sir, hats off to you, and I know that you are having a lot of initiatives in your mind. Morning, just I had a call with him, and that time also he said he just reminded me about the program. Then I asked him about the other thing. Then he said, sir, we are also inviting Jeurkar sir, and he is eminent metallurgist, and he is always helping our institute. See, one thing, industry is ready to get associated with institute. They are ready to help you. Only thing is that we have to approach them, and we have to work as per their convenience, because they have certain limitations, they have some time constraint, and if you adjust with them, definitely you will have a good interaction, and that definitely helps the institute as well as to the students. And if you consider this research paper concept, one thing I'll tell you, when I was in MSBT, I was working as a deputy secretary, that time the The initiative of project competition was undertaken. That time, Honorable Dr. Khodke sir was the director of MSBT, and he was also having a visionary approach. And he adopted this project competition. And that time, see, organizing a project competition is a different thing. Just it is a new concept, or even lot of institutes are organizing this project competition. But the basic concept behind that was is that we should encourage the patenting for the eligible students. And that way, those students who were coming out with the those who were selected, that is first or second prize winners, we gave all assistance for their patenting. We funded them. We have appointed one specialist who was assisting them in this patenting, and many patents were in pipeline. So that was the basic motto that he said. That see, one thing in polytechnic also they are doing good job. Good projects, people are also innovative, but only thing is that is not done in a proper way. So we should encourage them so that new projects will come out, and at the same time they will have some patenting. So this is the concept he adopted that time, and I feel this is an innovative concept, and the result is that students are doing a lot of things. One thing I'll tell you, that if you consider our Indian people, we people are quite intelligent. We are proud to have our many eminent personalities working at the top bosses in different multinationals, that is Microsoft, Google, Twitter, and so on and so on. You name the company, you'll find many of our Indians, they are working at the top, working at the top bosses or in a top management level. And forget about those who are working at a lower level. They are many and many much more. So such intelligent people we are having, but only thing is that we don't know how to present ourselves. So this patenting and all is one way to present ourselves. While talking about this patenting and all, you can say that I feel very sad that many of our faculty members, they are already having in their mind to go for PhD, or they are doing that PhD work, even they are completing their PhD in the best manner. But only thing is that they are not interested in giving their knowledge to society. Because whatever the research they have done, they do research or they work on it till their PhD is received. Once they have their PhD, they forget about that topic. They don't think of using it for the social benefit or benefit of the society, or they don't think to go do further research in that. Because see, if you do some further research in that, that definitely will be of immense use to the society. And one important thing is that if you see the students, when we see our students, there are all types of students, that is meritorious students having high merit, whereas very few many students are there who are just able to pass, or who are happy with if they pass the and you complete the course in a good manner. But if you go in detail, you will find that there are many students who are innovative. So just if you give them the ideas, or if you give them the scope, they come out with different new concepts, new ideas, and definitely that helps to our society also. Now, if you consider this program, this is an AICT-IST sponsored program. So at the same time, when this is the AICT-IST program, it's my duty to congratulate you for getting this program selected, because there is heavy demand for these programs. And one thing I'll tell you, the scrutiny committee was consisting of vice chancellors also and eminent personalities, and they have gone through every proposal in depth, and after detailed scrutiny, whatever proposal they feel appropriate, that based on the credentials of the institute, credentials of the coordinator, and at the same time important criteria as a topic, and based on that they have finalized the project, the institutes to awarding the programs, and they have finalized the FDPs. And I really congratulate that you have passed all these hurdles and you got this program. So that is a credit to you. And see, this the basic concept of this training program is that faculty should be given exposure to new trends or latest developments, or they should learn learn the things out of their curriculum or out of their regular routine. That is, see, this one thing, whatever the topic you have covered, this is not a regular topic. Those only who are interested in doing PhD, or those who are interested in that, they only think of that. And many times it is observed that the faculties who are interested in going for PhD, they are not aware about the concepts or the mode or the procedure. They are not aware about they are not aware about anything. So such type of training programs give them an idea, and that definitely help them to achieve success. I feel that those participants who are here, many of them will go for this PhD, or already some of them must have completed this, and many of them will maybe going in future also. So I wish great success for them, and I feel this program is of tremendous use in future. Now the basic idea behind these programs is to give knowledge in emerging areas. When you consider the present scenario, the technology change, it is the basic, you can say that this is the basic problem for we faculty members, because due to technologies, society is developing, everything, a lot of developments are taking place. But the main problem is that we have to prepare the students to face all these challenges. And our problem is that when you see in the situation, that technology which was used yesterday is becoming obsolete today. What the technology we are using today, that is going to become obsolete tomorrow. And then the question arises, what is the technology that will be used in future? Can you identify it? Can you predict it? It's not easy to predict. Means we can identify the different areas. That is, we can say that there is good scope for AI, ML, IoT will be there, 3D printing will be there, cyber security is also important criteria, blockchain is there, so many things are there. Okay, all these are the broad outline, but how they will come, how they are going to impact our society or our technology, can you imagine? No, it is not possible, because there is no one can predict it, because the way in which the technology is developing throughout the world, you cannot imagine. And under such situation, we have to prepare our students to face such challenges. Now they have to face the challenges, they have to go for the jobs which are not known. For example, that today we need driver, because for any institute or anywhere, or for us also, we feel that if the driver is there, it is better. But in few years, this post is going to become obsolete, because when self-driven cars are going to come, what is the use of driver then? So many new changes are going to come, and we have to prepare our students for that, and that is the basic concept that faculty should be trained first. Even if you, I think you must have organized the one lecture on national education policy also. So in that, it is clearly stated that faculty should undergo different types of training at every year. Now, when I joined Polytechnic, or when I was serving, the basic concept of training was to get the certificate and use it for senior scale or selection scale or for promotion or something, or to enhance the biodata. But now it is not the case. Whatever that is another advantage. But only thing is that you have to update your knowledge, and that is basic requirement. Suppose if I say that I am working in a government institute, or I am working in a very good institute which is have good reputation, and I don't have to do anything for this, definitely you are going to become obsolete. And just imagine, if you become obsolete, what will be your value in your institute only? You will not have any value in the institute. Then if you don't have value in the institute, what is going to happen with your future? And that is why I request all the participants to always, you have to learn the things, be always a student and learn the things, whatever new things are coming, get well versed with them, and that is going to help you in future also. So we also are doing some initiatives in this regard. Within 2 minutes, I'll tell you one latest initiative which we are doing. We have collaborated with BNY Mellon, a multinational company, and under that, we are organizing training programs in artificial intelligence and machine learning, IoT, and so on, means these emerging fields. The basic concept of this is that it is around 2 months vigorous training. It is not a simple 1 week or something like that. 2 months training will be given by expert person, so that faculty will learn a lot about that topic. And only thing is that for that, institute can nominate 2 faculties for IoT, 2 faculties for AIML. So once the nomination comes from the institute, there will be a national screening test, and based on the performance of the test, the participants will be selected for this IoT program and for AIML program. One important feature of this IoT program is that we are providing toolkit to the participants to undergo practical. Means you If you are performing well, definitely you will get the toolkit also. Means you don't have to spend money for toolkit. That toolkit will be giving, and after completion of the program in a successful way, the toolkit will be yours. We are not asking you to return it. So that is the thing, means they should do something in that area. Then you will say that when IST is doing, we are thinking about the faculties and we are thinking about the students also. So the basic one condition is there for this program. So the condition is that after successful completion of this program, the faculty must train at least 100 students from their institute in this emerging area. Means if they undergo training in AIML, they have to train 100 students in AIML. If they undergo in IoT, they have to train in IoT. So this way, this is the train the trainer program, and I am happy to say that it is having good, very good response from all over India. Already we have completed 2 batches of AIML, and third batch already we have announced. First batch of IoT is already in progress, and second batch is already announced. So the all participants who are interested, or those they can pass this information to their institute or to their colleagues, so that they can take benefit of this, and that will be helpful for the institute as well as for the faculty individual. So with this, once again at the end, I really appreciate the efforts taken by the Chogule sir and his coordinating team, because just remember, organizing a program is a very difficult thing. It requires, I think they must be working for about 1 month for this, and to attend the program is a very simple thing. So I feel we have already appreciated the efforts taken by them, and I know that they are always with us for various endeavors of IST in past also, and future also they will be with us. And with this, I wish great success for their future activities also, and definitely they will arrange such innovative activities for the betterment of faculty as well as for the students, and always with us, with AICT and IST, to achieve different things. One thing I forgot to mention is that AICT is also organizing various activities, and Colonel Venkat, Director of Faculty Development Cell, he is the person behind this, who is doing a lot of efforts for faculty development. So I also urge participants that we have a habit of browsing AICT website. There you will come across various initiatives for the students, the institute, and for the faculties, and take maximum advantage of all those things, schemes for betterment of you as well as your institute. So with this, once again, I'm thankful to management, particularly Chogule sir and others, for giving me an opportunity to interact with new people, and I success for their future endeavors. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. As we all know that change is the only permanent thing in world, and rightly said by you, the changing technology, the evergreen technology, the cutthroat technology, what we say, it's changing day by day, and we need to be in sync with that technology. So with this note, I wish to request Vaidya sir, that during organizing this event, we have a limitation of only 100 participants. So many of the participants are wish to have this program one more time. Like we did last year, we have conducted the teaching learning pedagogies initiative in 3 phases, and we have covered more than 2000 faculty members in that. But for this innovative topic of research paper writing and IP rights, we have a limitation of only 100 participants. So on behalf of organizing committee, I sincerely request you, sir, to permit us to conduct this program, so that we can accommodate this thing with the many more faculty.
That is a good thing, sir. That is a good request from your side, and we are also thinking in that direction. So we have a discussion with AICT. So the thing is that this is the first set of programs they have allotted. And okay. Another thing, just already you opened this topic. So shortly, I think yesterday you must have received the feedback form from our office. If you have not received, then you just inquire with our office, or you can tell me, I'll see that you'll get it. The thing is that all participants who are eligible for certification as per our criteria, they have to fill that form, and at the same time there is one questionnaire type feedback for coordinator also. The purpose behind that is that once we have the feedback form and all these information, we have to support a report to AICT about these the first set of programs, and based on the output of these programs, AICT is going to grant two more sets just like a previous one to us. So that is why I request you to give the information at an earliest, and already we are in constant touch with AICT. So they are asking us, sir, you submit us the report. Let us see. Last time also it was excellent. The programs were conducted in an excellent manner. And this also, they are saying that you just give us the report and then we'll consider your case. Don't worry. So that is why I appeal you to do this. And one thing, sir, I feel sorry to state that since I think there may be a registration of 100 participants, but only 43 participants I am observing here. And out of that, few are from your institute only, means they are not, they may not be participants. So I feel that, and one thing I will request you that please follow the criteria strictly for award of certificate. Yeah, right, because that is the basic. See, that is the basic instruction from AICT and particularly Colonel Mukesh sir also. Sir, we are doing a lot of effort. Our institute is taking tremendous efforts to organizing these programs, and it is the duty of the participants to give proper respect to such all efforts. So if they are not attending, means they are not fulfilling the criteria, do not give them the certificate.
Yes, sir. We have put the filter there. Yeah. We are going to scrutinize everything, their attendance, the feedback, and the daily test link as per the guidelines of AICT.
And those who are fulfilling the criteria, there is no problem for that. We have to give them, we will give it.
Yeah, we are going to give the certificate to those participants only. For rest of them, no, those who have just registered, we are not going to allow them for the certificates.
And so, one thing I will appeal you that if you send the information at an earliest, we'll issue the certificate immediately. That's not the problem. Yeah.
Right, sir. We are on it.
Yeah. You don't wait for all other reports. The reports you'll be sending in due course with all those formalities, whatever you are supposed to complete. But you can initially, you can send these details for certification and we'll give them certificate. The procedure will be, we'll prepare the certificates in a soft copy that will be given to you, and you have to forward it to all eligible participants.
Right, sir. We will do that. In next 3-4 working days, we are going to submit.
You take your own time, sir. Just right. Reminded you. No problem. Yeah, and I know that under when Chaguli sir is there, you will work very promptly.
Right, sir. Thank you. Very good. Dear participants, now we are at the end, and I request Head of Mechanical Engineering Department, Mr. S.K. Mohite, sir, to give a vote of thanks of this valedictory function.
Thank you, Kulkarni sir, for giving me this opportunity of vote of thanks. First of all, I would like to thank AICT and IST for screening our proposal, selecting our proposal, and sponsoring for our proposal. On behalf of organizing team, I am grateful Honorable Colonel B. Venkat sir, Director of Faculty Development Cell AICT New Delhi, Dr. P. K. Desai sir, President of IST New Delhi, Professor Vijay Vaidya sir, Executive Secretary IST New Delhi, Engineer Shekhar Jewalkar sir, Honorable President of Shanti Engineering Society, Sri A.J. Patil sir, and Secretary S.A. Patil sir. I would like to thank all the speakers, Dr. Aradhya Kumar from IIT Bombay, Professor Mrs. S.A. Sakre Madam, Sri Rajesh Kambhaj sir, Dr. Anika Devakar Madam from IIT Bombay, Dr. S.S. Wangikar sir, Dr. Vivi Poddar sir, Dr. P.K. Ashwini Kumar sir, Professor S.N. Upadhyay sir, Mr. Sunil Sabre, Mr. Anish Sastrode, Mr. Harikasad Madra, and Engineer Jayukur sir. I also thank the coordinator of this event and principal of our polytechnic, Dr. M.A. Zawale sir, for coordinating and organizing such a wonderful event. I thank our vice principal, Sri James Jacketer sir, for their valuable guidance. I also thank all the other departments and my colleagues for their support. And lastly, I would like to thank the dear participants for sparing their valuable time. It's been great pleasure to host you all here. I would like to thank Sprint and Infront Media for covering this event. Thank you. Thank you, everyone. Over to you, Kulkarni.
Thank you, sir. With the permission of authorities, I declare the event is over. All the participants are requested to fill the feedback form and attempt final test based on the topic that we have learned. We are sharing the link in next 15 minutes or around at half an hour. We'll share at 1:30 p.m. So thank you. God bless all. Sarvetra sukhinas santu, sarve santu niramayaha, sarve bhadrani pashantu, ma kashchit dukham apnaya. Om Shanti. Thank you, everyone. Thanks for your participation. Thank you, Vaidya sir, and all the dignitaries present.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Kulkarni sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.